Hey, what's up everyone? Neo Scyther here with another look at a game demo, and this time I'm taking a look at Ford in the Sky. This one, really don't know how to put it at the beginning, so I'll just kind of describe it as I go here. Essentially, the legend goes in the game that there's a witch that lives in the Sky Tower, and it's horrid and evil looking, everyone feared her, all that jazz. She sees all these crystals and attacks the people of the Sky Tower, though some are lucky enough to escape. And a young princess decides to take it upon herself to expel the witch from the tower. Now, each level, the Sky Tower, there's 100 crystal fragments. And every 33 you grab will form one section of the memory of the tower. It's not something I noticed while playing. Maybe it's something that happens after each stage outside the demo. But apparently there are 100 crystal fragments in each stage. What drew me into looking at this game is that, well, it's a platformer. And I'm into platforming, even though it's a 3D platformer. And I think one or two of the reviews said that the combat's similar to The Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time. I don't know where they got that. I mean, she has a sword, and she has a backflip she can dodge. And that makes it like Ocarina of Time, apparently. I would actually compare it more to your typical hack and slash, especially those where you have two types of attacks. You have your basic normal attacks, and you have your strong attacks. In most of those games, you can hit your normal attack button up to 5 times or so to do like a 5-hit combo. The strong attack you can do up to 3. Most games like this that I've played anyways, you can combine the two and do a strong attack and a normal attack. You start off doing normal attacks and maybe in there you throw in a strong attack, and it kind of does different combos. I don't think you can do that here. I couldn't figure that out. There are also puzzles in the game. There are a few combat scenarios, but there's also quite a few puzzles. One you just saw were spikes coming up out of the ground. Another one are these little blocks and switches here. For each of these blocks, there's a switch on the block and a switch off the block. They both do the same thing. They move the block. The one off the block, I'm guessing, is if you need to recall it back for some reason. Like maybe you fall off a certain part of the tower, you have to climb back up. It makes sense. There's one little annoyance to that, though. And that's what you're going to see here. And that is, with this block, if you hit the wrong switch, it pretty much goes up and around, and it takes a minute. And you have to wait for the block to completely stop before you can hit the switch again to bring it back. It's not terrible. It's just kind of tedious if you accidentally hit the switch. Thankfully, these little blocks aren't your only puzzles, as you've also got a couple sections where you have these crates you gotta move around, but just done by pushing them, which they seem to work on like a four-direction plane for some reason, and you use them to get up on your platforms. There's one towards the end that's actually rather interesting, and where you gotta push the crate onto one of the movable blocks, hit the switch to move the block, push the crate onto another block, hit the switch to move that block, push the crate one more time, and then climb up to get to your last section with crystals. Again, in the demo, you don't really see what happens when you get 100 crystals, or 33 even, I guess. So I would guess that's something that you'll see in the demo, or you'll see outside the demo. Another puzzle type, I guess you could say, are these spikes that come out of the walls and the ceilings. And thankfully, you have a lot of health in this demo. I'm guessing this is your starting health overall. Because finding the patterns of some of these could be a pain. The ones coming out of the walls aren't bad, but the ones coming out of the ceiling can be disorienting because, well, let me just take a look at this. I essentially just gave up and started forcing my way through. There's not a whole lot to say beyond that. I mean, I had a couple times where I fell off these moving platforms that you're seeing here, and it was my own stupidity. For some reason, was getting a little impatient, wasn't paying attention, so that was my own fault. And apparently, I don't know if you just cannot die in this game unless you run out of health. Because apparently, whenever you fall, you say hi to your little hot air balloon, and it carries you back up. Hot air balloon just goes, poof, here I am. So apparently, that you can't die by falling down a hole. And beyond that, the last thing that really comment on the stage itself is there's a demo towards the end that, again, has those little blocks that move when you hit the switches. But they're unique in that you have two or three different blocks you gotta kind of move into positions with the switches. And you gotta get them in the right position so you can actually go ahead and climb up them. It's not difficult. Then again, this is the first stage. So I can't imagine they would give you a really difficult puzzle in the very first stage. But if there are more puzzles like that, that would be enjoyable. I would like something like that, to be honest. Those are pretty fun. So, overall, it wasn't too bad of a demo. The puzzles were simple. Combat, for the most part, is simple. Except for towards the end, you get one or two of the stronger little skeleton things you're trying to fight. And unlike the weaker skeletons, the stronger ones, they take a lot of hits to take down. So you literally have to get in there, get your shots in, and then just back out, make sure nothing else hits you with these little blue energy orb things, whatever you want to call them. And then the end is just you hop into your hot air balloon, and that's it. And that's all there is to the demo. There's not a whole lot to it, but it is enjoyable. If you like platformers like this, you'd probably want to give this one a shot. Now, I know I keep saying that this is a game I'll probably buy at some point. Almost none of the times I've said that, I've actually bought the game yet. Except for Jet Gunner. The reason for that is, I have 220 games on Steam. I'm trying to avoid buying a lot more. So just because I say a game is, I like the demo, I would recommend it, I would probably pick it up at some point, doesn't mean I'm going to pick it up like right now. But this is one I wouldn't mind exploring down the road, maybe once I clear out some more of my games on Steam. Lord knows that's going to take a while though, but this is one I wouldn't mind revisiting. So that's all I've got for Forward in the Sky. If you like these sort of 3D platformers, I'd definitely say give it a shot, see what you think. And with that, that's all I've got, so I will see you next time.